Oh, I don't know how I missed that one.
Howdy folks, welcome to LMP3 at Imola. And in a nutshell, first race of the week, and we're not going. Can we go, please? And I've got Mr. Blinky ahead of me. Why are we not going? Thank you. And yeah, in a nutshell, I'm doing this race, so you hopefully can see the shenanigans that happen. And well, in a nutshell, there was only one split, annoyingly. I'm kind of looking forward to Imola. I've been in love with this LMP3 at the minute. And I kind of hope it lasts. But turn one, down a big long straight, you probably know what's going to happen. Oh, it's happened already.
Sorry, I'm so sorry, I didn't see this.
Well, that's a few freebies, and there's a few more.
So sorry about that. Round one.
That off track is horrible.
I want your front in that, sorry about that.
Right, let's crack on. Don't want to lose sight of the pack ahead, really. If you are thinking of racing this week, have some SR in the bank, because these off tracks are horrible. Cool. How many laps are we doing? 13, it reckons. There it is. Off track. Damn it. It was always going to happen around here, wasn't it? It was always going to happen. Little bit slidey through there. Need to be in the 39s. 38 even. 39.7. Hate that traction control. Really, really despise that traction control. Good exit, mi amigo. Meh, I'll take that off, Craig. Head down, eyes forward. Well, that was nice of that dude. You may recognize the name of car number 8. Just get on throttle there. Let the car settle down. That was the definition of a late move. Yeah, the idea is to hit the apex. Tickles me, things like that. It does tickle me. Moves really late into the braking zone of turn one. He does leave us a space, but still really, really late. And then tries to dive bomb stupidly into the hairpin, runs off the track, and then we got the inside. Literally, what is the point? Do the safety wiggle. I'm hoping I can get a good suck here. Guy ahead just disappeared. He's back. Come on, let's go get David Bowie. Let's go, David. Oh, we got a lap car ahead. That could be fun. He's got to have an off track, surely. Oh, spin up, stay there, please. I'll take that off track. It's fine. I've got 17 X's, may as well use them all. Not an off track iRacing.
Oh, don't know how I missed that one.
My life was flashing before my eyes. Not off track. Silly iRacing. That could be an off track. Almost missed your breaking point. How many laps have you got left? Maybe three? Alright, what's Matey Boy doing over here? He's doing 38 nines. Okay, we're quite similar on pace. The 38.4. Cool. I mean, it had an off track, but we'll gloss over that. Come on, I want to catch up with the dude ahead. Not by doing that, I ain't. That was slow through there. What was I doing that for? It's not going to be enough, is it? Damn it! That's not good. It was in my car, by the way, that that hand gesture. Apex in there somewhere. locking that rear axle. I'm braking too heavily into that last corner. You may have heard the revs die slightly. White flag. I'm gonna see if I can get into the low 38s really. Goodness, that wasn't an off track. See, now I'm taking chunks of time out of him. That's annoying. Poor exit there, but hopefully we're the fastest lap of the race. Ha 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 ha, 37.9. I'll take that. Should have done that pace all the way through the race, but hey ho. Right then, that wasn't a bad race, and I'm joined now by my partner in crime, Mr. Booty. So, that wasn't half bad, was it?
I enjoyed that and kept it relatively clean as well.
Yeah, that wasn't too bad. I mean, that did you have issues with that car fork dude?
He sent it up the inside. I don't think it was issues. He sent it up the inside of the hairpin on one lap and then properly squeezed me to the outside, which I think is just a lack of
grip understeer slash talent.
Yeah.
So
we had a bit of a battle up to the next corner. I think he yielded for me.
Okay, fair enough then.
And then he got me later. He got me at the end of the race.
I got alongside him coming down the straight to overtake him, and then he moved across on me in like the braking zone of turn one, and I didn't like that very much. And then he literally dive bombed it up turn seven, the hairpin, completely missed the apex, and I just undercut him. It's like, how do you? It didn't work last time you tried to dive bomb someone, i.e. you. So then he tried to do the same thing again and got the same result. So there's, I don't see the point of that. But it was like I say, there was no contact. I don't know how I survived that that P4 guy that spun in front of us going through whatever it's called. Where is it? Aquamilirali? He spun in there. I don't know how I missed him through there.
Yeah, I just saw the smoke and kept going and... Yeah, unfortunately, that cost me half a second to Antonio, but it is what it is.
Yeah, I'll probably put a little clip above my head or something, because that was very snug. But yeah, P4 and a P6. Annoyingly, you gained 27 IR, and I gained 9. All of that for 9 IR.
Was it a bit chaotic on the first lap? Because you seem to be very close after like 2 laps to me.
Yeah, about 3 or 4 people had issues, so... It was going to happen. Imola, long straight, little bit of slipstream in this car that doesn't seem... It does exist when you're, like, right up there, Jaxi, but it doesn't exist otherwise, does it? But, yeah. Hope you learned something from that one. Be careful when you're racing out here, because there are some crazy people, and lap one is always carnage around here, particularly down in turn one, because it is quite snug. Otherwise, don't forget to like and subscribe and do that lovely YouTube stuff. Say goodbye, Booty.
Goodbye, Booty.
Have fun, guys. See you in a bit. Bye-bye.